What you'll see me demo today all came about as I attempted to duplicate a technique Ellie, who's one of our Joggles customers, told me about. She'd played around and come up with this, but I never was able to get results that I liked well enough, that were predictable enough that I could actually show you how to do it. But at the end of the day, all of that monkeying around led me to these other techniques that I'm going to share with you today. So the first thing I'm going to do is actually back up to a video that I did several weeks ago where I combined a water-based product on top of alcohol ink, on top of wet alcohol ink. This is kind of a take on that, and so what I'm using as my water-based product are Ranger's mica sprays, and though it looks like this is pink liquid, it's actually not. It's just because some of the mica, you can see some of it's accumulated in the bottom, some of that mica is actually up and moving around in the liquid. Unlike a Lindy's where the liquid is colored and the mica itself is colored, maybe similar or maybe something completely different, this is going to allow me to put down some fairly subtle effects. It can be a little bit more dramatic. It depends on what color you put what color on, and we'll get there. But it allows me to get these really interesting effects. I can add some mica, I can add some shimmer, and it really produces some interesting results. So the first thing I want to do is let you know that I'm working with a piece of 5x7 white Yupo. Now what you'll also notice is that I'm working on something else. In the past, I've worked directly on my nonstick craft sheet, which is what my surface of my workbench is covered with, but I've discovered that if I put down a sheet of palette paper, it really helps contain the mess and it makes cleanup a whole heck of a lot easier. So I've really switched over to doing that. Now, I don't only use clean sheets. I'll come back and reuse sheets that have stuff accumulated, but for making it easy for you to see what's going on here without any distractions, I'm just starting with a clean sheet. So what I'm going to do is work with three colors of alcohol ink, and this is one of the sprays from Wendy Vecchi's set of three. This is Buttercup. So I'm going to put some color down. I'm going to manipulate it using this long straw, which is going to allow me to get some patterning like what you see here, but before it's all dry, I'm going to hit that with the spray, and you'll see that awesome pattern that happens. So I'm going to start by just putting down some color. There's no pattern as I put it down. I just want to get the color down there, and then I can start manipulating it with the coffee stirrer. Whoops, and I'm knocking things over. So it's just a matter of moving the color around, and there's going to be some mixing. As you know, that most of the colors of alcohol ink that you work with, it's pretty darn difficult to make mud. And certainly when I'm using colors like I did here, where they're all pretty much from the same side of the color wheel, making mud is almost next to impossible. Well, I don't know what that is, but we're going to get it out of here. So one of the first things that you're going to notice is as I manipulate this in the wet alcohol ink, all of those marks are going to soften and blend back out because this is still pretty wet. But if I start pushing some of that alcohol ink off and I start manipulating what's left, where the ink starts to dry, those patterns will remain. But I don't want this to all be dry because if it is, then I'm not going to get the reaction I'm looking for when I spritz it with the mica spray. So this is pretty good. I've got, you can see that the patterns are starting to stay, which tells me that the ink is starting to dry. I can blow on it a little bit to hasten that evaporative process, and then I'm going to come back with the mica spray and I'm going to spritz. So I'm going to put some yellow on there, and how wicked is that? How awesome is that patterning that just happens when the water-based product reacts with the mica spray? So what I need to do is let this dry, and I'll come back and I'm going to show you how you can take a stencil with judicious amounts of alcohol applied to a piece of paper towel. We're going to do this reduction stenciling thing a la Dina Wakely. Here's the piece. It's all dry. I did use a heat tool on it, but obviously a word of warning. Yupo is plastic and it doesn't tear, it doesn't rip, it doesn't do anything, but it will bend and it will crumple if you apply too much heat to it. So as long as you kind of waft the heat around it, that'll hasten the drying process without actually buckling the Yupo. But it's perfect for work with alcohol ink like this because it doesn't buckle and it just lets you work without any of that aggravation. You can see all the cool patterning that happened from the coffee stirrer I used and then that bloom and burst thing that happened when I hit the wet alcohol ink with the mica spray. So what I want to show you is how to go from this to something that looks like this. And I'm basically going to use alcohol and remove some stuff through the openings of this stencil. And that's how I'm going to accomplish that kind of reduction stenciling thing, very similar to what Dina Wakely does. So I don't want this to move, and I want to be able to use two hands. And toward that end, I'm just going to tape everything in place. It's going to make life easier as I go along. I've tried it without, and it's very aggravating. So I'm going to avoid the areas. I don't want to tape over the Yupo. I want to leave all of that open. So I have 91% isopropyl alcohol in a properly labeled bottle, because at a glance this could be water and you don't want to find out that it's not. You don't want to find out the hard way that it's not. This is just Ranger's empty mister bottle and it works great. The alcohol does not affect the sprayer or the mechanism at all. This is a piece of plain old paper towel. I have tried this a couple of ways and discovered that if I take and I try to moisten my paper towel with the bottle of alcohol itself, I end up with way too much on there and I can't control the results. So here's what I did. I'm going to just move this forward. I don't want to spritz on here. I'm going to use two sprays to start with because I've got a perfectly dry piece of paper toweling. And after that, I'm only going to use one spritz at a time, because anything more than that one spritz means I've got too much alcohol and I'm actually going to find that it leaks underneath the edges of the stencil. So all I'm going to do is use it to remove color through the openings in the stencil. Now, I don't have a Q-tip handy, but if you have them, you can certainly use it in small areas like around these stamens on these particular flower petals. I'm not going to worry about it. This is probably not anything I'm going to keep, but this is the process. And so you go along, and when you have used up kind of the damp alcohol that's in there, you come back and you do it again. You start with a fresh spritz and you can come back in and start removing color again. Now, how much you remove is entirely up to you. The one that I did with Love Twist, which I'm going to bring back out in a second, I'm not going to do this entire piece, but the one that I did with Love Twist, I was careful to pretty much take most of that ink out from the stencil opening because I really wanted the pattern to be quite obvious. But you can see it's not difficult. You can just go right along and get this done. So that's the process. It really is that simple. If I slide this out of here, you can see the beginnings of what's going on. Now, interestingly enough, you'll never get back to perfectly white Yupo like what you see here. Alcohol ink does stain the body of this, does stain the Yupo itself. So you'll remove most of the color, but you're not going to remove all of it. Now, when you're done and you have something kind of like this, what you're left with is an opportunity to come in and highlight those designs in some fashion. You also have a piece that you can die cut. This is not cut straight. I just hacked up some larger pieces into smaller workable sections. And so I could straighten up all of these four sides, square it up, and this could be a first layer on a card that I could then put some other things on the top. But what I found that's really fun to do, so this is Pebbio's Deco Marker. These are water-based products that are permanent when they're dry. And all I'm doing, this is the 0.7 tip, all I'm doing is just coming in and dotting around each of the elements that appear when you take the alcohol ink through the opening or out through the openings of the stencil, and it really is this simple. Now, if I wanted to, all of those hearts could become fodder for doodles. I just chose to keep it simple and to do this. So this is one technique that's going to use a background to start with. I have another one that I'm going to show you in just a moment that's going to also work with a stencil, but this time we're going to add color through the opening, which produces a very different result. You're going to get something very, very different that, whoops, I guess we don't need that piece of tape, that is much busier, but produces an effect that in some cases might be exactly what you're looking for. I have my pattern background ready to go. I'm going to bring in a stencil and lay it on here. It doesn't matter how you apply it in terms of the pattern. You're going to get so much movement of alcohol ink, as you can see by this example, that it's not going to make a whole heck of a lot of difference. I am going to tape this in place, though, just so that the thing doesn't skitter around on my workbench. I can kind of keep it in one spot. So this process actually requires a little bit more patience. You've got to give it a little bit of time to dry. I'm going to hasten that with the heat tool, again, being careful that I don't buckle the Yupo. So I'm going to start by applying a couple of colors of alcohol ink. I may just stick with aqua. We'll have to kind of see how that goes. Now, I've got a little bit of lift going on right here. The alcohol ink is going to bleed under the openings of the stencil. There's really no way to avoid that. But what I'm going to do is use a piece of tape right here and just try to get that stencil down a little bit tighter to the surface. And I'm going to look around and see if there are any other places where that's happening. There's no way to prevent that movement of the alcohol under the edges of the stencil. You just can't. But you can minimize it a little bit in two ways. The first one is by keeping that stencil down tight to the surface. And the second one is with how much alcohol you actually apply. So what I'm going to do is just start putting color through the openings of the stencil. Now I'm probably not going to do this whole thing just because I don't want to take the time, but I think I am going to pick up a second color. So I'm also going to ignore the littler openings in here. I could do that, but again, it's just a time factor thing. As I work on camera, you don't need to see all of that craziness. So I'm just squeezing a little bit of ink into the openings, and I don't necessarily have to completely fill the openings. I can if I want. It's a matter of preference. So now let me grab this other color and let me do some on this other side and see what happens. So this is a pink, but it's a very different pink. If I want to mix some, I can certainly do that. So let's come in here and just drop a little bit in some of the petals on this particular flower. And as always, one color of alcohol ink has a tendency to push whatever's under it or near it out of the way, and you see that kind of happening here. So the process is to do this, and then I've got to get this to dry a little bit, because in the same way as I was moving the color on the background with the coffee stirrer and it kept moving while it was wet and those lines I was making became less distinct, the same thing will happen here. I want to kind of freeze or capture what's in here as much as possible to start with. And the way to do that is to get some of this to dry. So I'm going to fill in a few more of the openings, and then off camera I'll come back and I'm going to hit this. I'm not going to do anything other than heat it with a heat tool. So you're not going to miss anything. You're just, other than the boring part of, you know, watching paint dry, because really who needs to see that? And then I'm not going to wait until everything underneath is completely dry, but I am going to try to encourage it to be as dry as possible so that I don't get too much movement after the fact, which again I'm trying to minimize as much as possible. So let me just take a moment to dry this off, and then I'll come back and we'll do the big reveal. While I was drying, I took the opportunity to remove all the tape so that you don't have to see me fumbling around with that. So I've got my heat tool ready. I've pretty much hit this with enough heat so that the alcohol ink in the openings has evaporated off and it's fairly stable. What's probably not quite as stable is any of the ink that's leaked under the stencil, but again, that's part and parcel of this. So I'm going to pull the stencil off really quickly, and I'm going to come back with the heat tool so that I can help capture and freeze all of that ink in place by drying it off. So I'm kind of ready here, and I'm going to come in and start to do that. So what you can see is twofold. The first thing is that I had a really dirty stencil, so I've picked up some color, and actually that's not going anywhere, which is good. So I've picked up some color from the back of the stencil, and what's on here is a combination of ink, alcohol ink from previous things that I've been doing the last few days, and paint. Now the paint is kind of unperturbed by the alcohol ink, but certainly the alcohol ink that's on there would be regenerated, if you will, by whatever I put on top. But you can see how you get, I'm trying to do this without the bloody glare, you can see how you get all this really cool patterning that happens. Now I didn't spend a lot of time on this, I just wanted to get it done for you, but you can see that there's opportunities to create all kinds of really interesting things. And once again, I could come in, and let's get this palette paper out of the way, I could come in with a pen, if I could find my white deco marker, that's the big tip, which is not the one that I want. I'm looking for my white one, which was here just a moment ago, and of course I can't find it because that's the way these things go. So I'll just come back with the black. So I could do a couple of different things. I could pick up with that same dot patterning again. Now the colors here, the background is fairly dark, so the black is not going to just jump right off the surface, but here where it's lighter, you'll see that it will. And it's much more evident as I follow the shapes of the petals that happened when I put the ink through the openings of the stencil. So this is something that you can do. Now, some people might think of this as kind of a messy thing. I really like all the busyness that's going on here. It's a very different look from what you might get with most other techniques, but that leakage of the ink underneath the stencil is what creates all of this really interesting stuff. So here's my original background. You can see it here and here. I didn't actually get any ink under the stencil here. And here's where the other things kind of happen. Now there is the, if you choose to look at it as serendipitous, this is all the serendipitous stuff that happened by the alcohol ink loosening up alcohol ink that was already on the stencil, and it kind of transfers on. If you don't want that to happen, you should clean your stencil beforehand so that you know that there's no ink on there. So these are a couple of techniques that I really like a lot. And then the last one that I want to show you is going to utilize more mica, more shimmery stuff. I want to use De La Rowney's F&W Pearlescent Ink, which is very different from most other mica products, primarily because of the size of the granule, the size of the shiny stuff that's inside. And so it produces some really interesting effects. And this comes directly back to that video that I did about mixing your media, where I'm going to incorporate a water base onto, I'm going to incorporate alcohol ink onto a water-based product, and you're going to get all this weird, wild, wonderful blooming. This is an example of the last technique that I want to show you today. You can see all of the glimmer and all of the shimmer in the background. That's the F&W Pearlescent Ink. This happens to be the color named Genesis Green. I'm going to use Waterfall Green, which is actually a turquoise color. All of this other stuff, this is what happens when you put alcohol ink on it. And then the last thing that happens is I came in with one of the mica sprays, so I'm going to use that again. And what happens is when the mica spray hits the alcohol ink, it causes a further reaction. Now at that point, it's a little bit more subtle because it's already reacted with the water that's in the F&W Pearlescent Ink, but it still happens, and you can add some color on top of what you've already got there. So again, whoops, I have a piece of white Yupo, it's 5x7. I'm going to bring in some of the F&W Pearlescent Ink. I'm not going to bring in a ton, I don't need a lot, that's just crumbles from the edge of dried up ink. I'm going to squeeze a little bit out with the eyedropper after I shake it all up. The difference between this and most other products, as I said a moment ago, is the size of the particles that are in there. And it's very, very interesting. So I'm going to take some water, and this still has some Genesis Green in it, but that's fine. I'm going to take some water and just spread the product out. And if I think it's not wet enough, I'll grab my spray bottle and I'll mist it a little bit, although honestly at this point I think that it's just fine. So this is Waterfall Green. It's just a gorgeous color. I have those same three colors of alcohol ink that I used a moment ago, and so I'm just going to start dropping them on there, and you're going to see all this weird, wonderful blooming that happens when you get that reaction. So here's some of the yellow. You can see the alcohol ink causes this sort of gathering of the mica in the center, and then it blooms outward. Sometimes it's more predictable than others. Here you have kind of a different shape. So now what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to sprinkle the other colors so I can get some smaller droplets, and I'm going to do the same thing with this one. And how interesting is that? You can see the bleeding happening, you can see the blooming happening, you can see all the mica that gathers. So now what I'm going to do, I think this time I'm going to use, you know what, I'm going to come back to the yellow, primarily because it's going to fit in with what I've done, but it's also going to contrast with the background. How much of it we'll see remains to be seen, simply because, you know, you've got one color mica falling on another particulate matter that is also shimmery. I don't really know what it's going to do, but we're going to give it a shot. So I'm mostly going to spritz in the alcohol, and you can automatically see what happens when we get that weird reaction that causes that awesome patterning. So that's going on, and then in here, where there is alcohol, you also have a gathering of the mica that's in there. So you get this really wonderful thing. Now, what to do with it? As I said, it makes a great card. You can die cut these pieces. You can stamp on them and then cut the images out. You can use this in many different ways. Just let your imagination run free. But perhaps the most important thing that I want to tell you is the wonderful things that happen when you mix what essentially is like oil and water. You mix alcohol ink with a water-based product.